Hello and welcome to the Kaiser Craft blog. My name's Colette. Today I would love to share with you how I've made this cute little button box. When you remove the lid, it reveals four great chunky sized drawers that are just great for storing all sorts of items. I've chosen to put some buttons in this one. So let's get started. You'll need a piece of Kaiser Craft card. I've chosen weave here, and I need to cut this card so it's 6¼ inches by 12 inches. So I've popped it into my trimmer, lined it up at the 6¼ inch mark, and I'm going to go ahead and cut that. I now need to score this piece, which is going to be the base of our box. So I'm going to remove my straight cutter and pop in the crease and fold cutter. Or should I say the crease and fold blade? Okie doke. So now I'm going to rotate this 90 degrees and I'm going to score it at 3 inches, 6 inches, and 9 inches. And now all I need to do is to fold and crease with a bone folder. Fold and crease. Fold that last one and crease. So in effect what we've got here is the actual box wrapper. So I'm now going to set that aside and I'm going to go ahead and make my drawers. Or should I say boxes? And to do this, I'm going to need some card, and I'm going to need to cut that card 5⅞ inch square. So I'll pop that into my Kaiser Craft trimmer, and I need to cut it 5⅞, so that's going to be two tiny little marks before the 6. So two marks before the 6, that is 5⅞ inch. So I'm going to go ahead and cut that, but first I need to remove my crease and fold. I do that so often. What about you? I'm sure I'm not the only person that does that. So let's get the straight blade in nice and quickly. 5⅞ inch. I need to cut that. I'm going to rotate it because we want it to be 5⅞ inch square. And I need to cut that. Okay, now I need to score these little boxes. So again, removing my straight blade, I remembered that time, and popping in the crease and fold. And I'm going to score these at 1½ inches all the way around, so they're nice and deep. Now with the Kaiser trimmer, the furthest point on the right hand side is actually 1½ inches. So I like to just put my finger there, push this across, and I know that's 1½. So I'm going to rotate that now to get the other side. My finger's there, I can feel it. It's 1½. Rotate it. 1½. And the final one, my finger's there. 1½. If you don't want to use that finger method, you can just measure it under here. It more or less comes straight with the ruler on the left-hand side. So now those are all marked. All I need to do is just to fold those with my bone folder. Fold and crease. Fold and crease. And fold and crease. Now to actually make these, I like to take a little bit away from the corners. So I'm going to, on that score line on each of these sides, I'm going to cut a skinny little V on the flap end. So I'm leaving this bit intact. It's the flap end that I take the V away from. Make sure you get right into those corners. So it's the flap end I'm taking it away from. Doesn't matter how big or little it is. Okay, excellent. Now once I've done that, I'm ready to glue. And what we will do is we're going to turn that over so the right side is facing up. And I'm just going to put a little bit of adhesive on here. Now, when I'm doing boxes, drawers, or anything like this, I do like to use this tape here. It's an extremely tacky, strong tape. But just for speed on the camera, I'm going to be using this KaiserCraft adhesive. So I'm just going to turn that round. Now take care when you're folding it, because you just want to make sure that your edges are lined up nicely and the tops are in line. Okay, so I'll get this side here lined up nicely, tops are in line. Now what you'll need to do for this project is to make four of these little drawers, four of those drawers. And then once you've got the four of those drawers, you're going to take your box that we made earlier and you're going to put some of that really strong glue on here, and you're going to adhere one of them on top, and then you'll adhere one down here and the other two in a stepping motion going down. But remember, do the first one here and the second one down here, so you end up with your actual boxes. So you can see here what I've done, starting here, then to here, and then you put the second one down and then the third one. Okay, so that's our boxes and our liner done. So the only thing now that we need to do is to make the actual lid. Now for the lid, I'm going to need a piece of card that measures 7 inches by 7 inches. Okay, 7 inches by 7 inches. Now, I remember this time I need to change from my crease and fold over to my straight blade. Takes seconds to do, so really is no hassle at all. And it does give you a really good score when you're using that crease and fold. So I've cut my piece for the lid, which is 7 inches by 7 inches. And I'm going to score this all the way round. So changing over again. At 1, are you ready? 1 15/16. Yep, I know, it's a funny old measurement. So that is basically one little notch before the two on all sides. So there's the two, that's the one little notch on all sides. And I'm just going to score that all the way around. So to make the lid, it's really an identical process to making one of those little box drawers that we did. So once we've actually got all our measurements all the way around, we do exactly the same by cutting out each of those corners and adhering it, and we end up with another one of these that's going to be bigger, that will fit on top of our box. So I'm not going to go ahead and glue this because we've just done that. So that really shows you how to make this particular box. So you'll need the actual wrapper, you'll need the four drawers, and then you'll need the lid that will sit on top. And that will give you this cute little button box, which I absolutely adore. And then you can have fun decorating it. Decorate the pieces before you start sticking all the drawers and things down. It just makes them all so much nicer. So that's my button box. I hope that's given you some inspiration for some storage ideas. And before I go, just look at this lovely metalwork that KaiserCraft are now actually distributing. Particularly love these corners. They give the actual box a really nice look. You just buy them in packets like this, and you just simply glue them in place. They're so much fun. So thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you have fun making your boxes. Bye for now.